Mr. Pioneer competition. Tonight we have 12 contestants who will be competing for the title of Mr. Pioneer 2011. All of our contestants will participate in two competition categories. The categories are Dress to Impress and the Best Pickup Line. Based on their scores in those categories, our judges will then narrow down to the top six contestants. Those top six contestants will then compete in the final two categories, which are karaoke and the on-stage questions.
Then, you, the audience, will actually determine who will win Mr. Pioneer. You will do the voting via text message, and you will give more details about that tonight part. But for now, please show respect for tonight's contestants and those around you by putting your phones on silent and putting them away. Also, make sure tonight you encourage those who are out here on stage. Let's give our contestants a round of
applause. All right, so you know the real reason why I couldn't be in the competition, right? Well, they said that real models couldn't be in the competition, so.
Really? Tell me, who do you model for?
Huh?
Who do you model for?
Who?
You
model
for.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Before we move on to the first competition category, we have a special performance for one of SMC's own. She is a member of the Pops Program Board, the SMC Troubadours. She has been writing and performing her own spoken words and her poems for several years and is a member of the group Lyrically Inclined. You may know her as SMC freshman Markeisha Nesbitt, but on stage she goes by a different name. Give it up for One Love.
L-O-V-E. I go so hard, yes, so small, spoken word, artist, so you ramp us back off. This round here had a whole crowd pop locking. So while you haters talking, I be hater walking, wearing my shades and doing my dance. You see, these haters got a schedule, but I got other plans to put my hater blockers on. Hey, I put my hater blockers on. Hey, I put my hater blockers on. Move them. Then I look in the mirror and make sure my swag tight. So if you got a hater, put your hands up high. Do your dance while you say your haters goodbye. When I go to the club, yes, I can go to the club. Not the big club, but the little teen club. Just thought I'd clarify that. I try not to hate on these dudes using pickup lines to so late, like, hey girl, if I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together. For what? Then he tells you put your number in his phone and vice versa, but don't call him until after 9. Well, but I can already tell this ain't gonna work, because I'm looking for somebody I can call or text anytime. What you want me to? Call you at 1 or 2 so you can come over and try to make it do what it do, leaving me speechless, breathless, and in a state of mind. Well, I just want to caress you, ooh. Or think about you all day until I come up with various ways just to tell you, hey, and I wait until 8:59, 9 o'clock, 9:01 to have our first official phone conversation. And I wait all day just to hear you say, yeah, I'ma call you back. Boy, stop. I'm a classy chick. So if you're trying to step to me, I'ma need you to upgrade. Starting with your prepaid phone that looks like the first phone I ever got. Scratches from the front to back, and your screen is cracked with the company's default ringtone is ever so whack. Yet you still got the nerve to try and make. Talking about you got a BlackBerry. Boy, you need to quit it, because besides your phone, the swagger that you lack, approaching me with your coogee, says Uji. Your Ed Hardy, it spells Ed Harley. And what really got me was your shirt with the back was Nike check. It was wet. It looked like you had been biting on your shirt neck, and I just don't understand what possessed you to holler at me. And after our third phone conversation, I figured you'd see that you and I are not meant to be. Yet out of all of the bad things I could have remembered him by, I decided to remember him by his fade. But in my phone, I just saved him as Mr. Prepaid. One love.
All right, it's time for our first competition category, which is Dress to Impress. Each contestant was instructed to choose an outfit that shows off his style and personality. Let's get started.
Before we move on to the next phase, let's take a moment to introduce tonight's judges.
All right, contestant number one, Cody Jackson.
Oh my God!
contestant number 9, Hunter to Riddle Heights.
Oh,
all
wow.
The way from the town of Hanklin, South Carolina. Hunter is 5'8 and enjoys cooking for your mama. A computer student, Hunter is a member of the Spanish Honor Society and is just that guy. He says the greatest thing about being a man is being able to engulf a woman with his arms to let her know she's safe and lucky. Contestant number 9, Hunter to Real High.
Contestant number 10, Andrew Price. The 6 month sophomore. Contestant number 10.
Come on,
Andre.
Guitar. At SMC, James is involved as a presidential ambassador, plays with the Overflow Band, and is part of the coaching staff for the women's basketball team. His ideal of a perfect day is a picnic lunch by a waterfall with a small rainbow as he serenades his lady. Contestant number 11, James Wood.
Contestant number
12,
James.
My baby must be nervous.
Pretty much anything illegal. At SEC, Jason is a member of the SEC track team and the college program. His idea of a perfect date would be taking his girl to party to tell her she can order anything off the menu. Then he would take a nice long romantic walk back to SEC to gas his expenses. After arriving on campus, Jason and his date would have a lovely night cat beating it off down in. It's a game of Call of Duty. The situation is, he gives his day a high five, an awkward hug, and then call his girlfriend and go to sleep. Number 12, Jason Clark.
All right, give it up for the contestants one more time.
Before we move on to the next phase of our competition, let's take
some time out of
tension.
Yeah, I'm
all right.
First, we have Emily Sachs. You know her best as the Director of Financial Aid. Did you also know that she competed in the Miss South Carolina pageant? She is a graduate of Anderson College, the mother of two toddlers, and husband to Jason Sachs. She loves coffee, and tonight she invites you to her unique class. Please welcome Emily Sachs.
Yay, Emily!
Our next judge also works in SMC's financial aid office. He is an SMC graduate and received his bachelor's degree from USC Upstate. Originally from Woodrow, South Carolina, he currently lives in Willard Hall, where he serves as an RHD. Give it up for Chris Robertson.
Our third judge currently
is
Mr. Spartanburg Methodist College, as well as an SMC staff. She is the RHD in Bridges Hall and graduates from SMC in 2009. In her free time, she works as the youth director at Cypress United Methodist Church in Greenville, South Carolina. Please welcome Amanda Gettings.
All right, it's now time to move on to the second phase of our competition. It's the best pickup line. Each contestant was asked to pick a female representative to assist them in tonight's competition. You already saw these lovely ladies during the opening number. These ladies, they get to specifically help with this part of tonight's competition.
Let's get started with contestant number 1, Cody Jackson.
Well, first of all, she's beautiful. Look at her.
she loves to draw, and she kept her life scholarship, which is most couldn't say they did. So she's very smart.
Yay! Yeah, girl.
And not only is she all of those things, she's also my best friend.
Okay, Cody, now is your time to impress your representative with your best pickup line.
Shay, you can fall from the sky, you can fall from a tree, but wherever you fall, I hope it's in love with me.
Too. So,
Now it's your turn to impress your representative with your best pickup line.
She's so pretty, I forgot my pickup line. Girl, you got an extra heart? Mine's been stolen.
Contestant number six, CJ Hires for Ashley McFadden.
My beautiful Miss Chocolate, Ashley McFadden.
Yeah. Yeah. Get it, Ashley.
That milk chocolate.
Be real. I met her since last year, and we've been good friends. And she's been through a lot. So I just want to be that special one to fix things for.
Okay, well, now it's your turn to impress your representative with your best pickup line.
Oh my God.
Dang, girl. For a second, I thought I went to heaven. Now that I see that I'm very much alive, I know this heaven has been brought to me. And you're the beautiful angel God has meant for me to see.
Thank you. If I never met you, I wouldn't like you. If I never liked you, I wouldn't love you. If I never loved you, I wouldn't miss you. But I can, I do, and I will.
She has dazzling brown eyes. She's from Darlington. And my favorite color is blue. She has blue in her hair.
Alright, now it's your turn to impress your representative with your best pickup line.
You know, girl, I usually talk in dimes, but you look like a four. Like a forever. Aww.
I know you ain't crying.
Contestant number 10, DeAndre.
Who?
DeAndre Price. And Escort Margaret.
My escort is Margaret. She's freshman.
Okay.
She's a beautiful singer, a mother of a beautiful daughter. And though we've been friends for a short amount of time, she's a close friend.
All right, DeAndre, now impress her with your best pickup line.
When I'm interested in somebody, I don't use a pickup line, unlike some other people.
All right, contestant number 11, James Williams, whose representative is Erica Hickson.
Yeah, James!
Well, this is Erica. She's not only gorgeous, but she's got an awesome sense of humor, and she's one of my good friends. I'm lucky to have her for an escort.
All right, James, now impress her with your best pickup line.
If you'll be my Dairy Queen, I'll be your Burger King. You treat me right, I'll do it your way.